All my life up until last year, I had no idea what race I was. You know, growing up, not only did I get questions and name calling from the white kids in my community, but I also got it from my fellow Vietnamese community as well. That was a bit of a struggle for me, but we never knew what that other part was that made up our mixed race identity. It was something I almost resented about myself, not knowing. In 2016, I took a DNA test to answer one question: who is my grandfather? It's a question that plagued my family for over 50 years. My mom is one of the thousands of Vietnamese children fathered by Americans during the Vietnam War. Growing up, I didn't know a lot about my grandmother's life during the Vietnam War. Whenever I would ask my grandmother, she would make it clear to me that she had a very hard life during that time. And I kind of got the sense that it was something that she wanted to just sort of hide. What I knew about my grandfather was that he was tall, that he looked a lot like me. He served in the US military, and he was an American who met and fell in love with my grandmother.
Bộ râu, ông đẹp trai lắm. Ông thon, ông ốm người giống phải mặt như vậy đâu. Mỗi lần cái ngoài cái vuốt tóc ông vậy nè, lại gần thì ngoài vuốt tóc, hay vuốt tóc.
Dạ, tôi nhớ là hồi lúc tôi chừng 5-6 tuổi là tôi biết tôi không có cha. Giống như là những đứa trẻ khác nó có cha.
Giờ má không biết nói làm sao, tại vì ông về, ông đâu cho má biết. Má biết cái địa chỉ này kia cái nọ đâu. Mà mẹ trả lời, má trả lời với con. Nói vậy đó.
The only existing photo of my grandmother and grandfather together was destroyed after the Viet Cong had entered my grandmother's village.
Tại vì bà ngoại sợ chị cộng vô, bà ngoại xé. Tại vì chị cộng vô thì bắt được cái tấm hình đó. Thì bà ngoại sợ bà ngoại chết. Cái gì ngoại cũng kỷ niệm của ổng là ngoại xé hết.
Tôi chỉ thấy trong cái hình, nhưng mà tôi chỉ thấy một cái tấm hình, tôi mới hỏi ông này là ai vậy má. Thì mẹ tôi mới nói là ba mày. Mẹ tôi chỉ nói vậy thôi, rồi cái tôi thấy mẹ tôi xé đôi nó ra. Xé đôi ra bà để trong cái lò củi bà đốt.
I think the fact that my mom didn't know who she was or that she didn't know her father was really painful for her.
Lúc đầu con tôi hồi lúc nó còn bé đâu, khoảng nó chừng 12 tuổi gì đó, nó thấy tôi buồn, tôi hay ao ước tôi có cha. Cái con tôi nó nói để nó lớn lên nó đi tìm ông ngoại cho.
I decided to do 23andMe to find out my ancestry once and for all. I just needed to know. This was my identity, and it was something that had eluded me for so long. When I got the genetic information back, I realized that my grandfather had to be an African-American man because of an African-American ancestry that I had. For me, it was a moment like, holy crap, like here it is, the questions that I've been asking all my life up until then. Who am I? You're African American. It was wild. It was truly wild.
Nhưng mà cái lúc mà con tôi nó tìm được ông ngoại, nó gọi phone cho tôi, nó nói là nó tìm được ông ngoại rồi, ông ngoại là Mỹ đen.
There was silence on the other end for a while.
Nó bất ngờ đến với tôi quá, tôi phải lặng yên một hồi chừng.
I think that there is a lot of deep-seated racism within the Vietnamese community, which is a big part of the reason why my grandmother might have hidden the fact that she knew my grandfather was an African-American man.
Tại vì bà ngoại lấy Mỹ đen có nhiều người người ta phản ảnh. Ngoại không ra gì cho nó lại đá chọi nữa. Nhưng mà ngoại thấy Mỹ đen, Mỹ trắng gì cũng vậy, nó tế nhị, nó thương, biết thương này kia nọ, ngoại thích.
Bà rất là sợ là người ta biết là tôi là lai người da đen.
Bởi vì ngoại giấu hết rồi, đâu có nói Mỹ đen cái gì đâu.
Hi, go. It took nearly 3 years in order to finally track down my grandfather. Eventually, we were able to connect to my grandfather's brother. I just sent him a message describing who I was looking for and that I had noticed that we were very related on the genetic makeup. He sent me a message back saying that the man that I was looking for was his brother. I had looked up who this man was online. I didn't come across a living address, but instead I came across an obituary. He had died in 2013 in Houston, Texas, and he was gone. I felt like I had missed my moment, almost like I was too late to find him. And he had no idea the life that we lived beyond him.
Lần đầu tiên tôi thấy cái hình của ba tôi thì tôi cảm thấy là tôi có cái nét giống ổng. Tôi giống, có thể là tôi giống ba tôi cái khuôn mặt một tí. Trong cái lúc đó tôi chỉ ngồi tôi khóc thôi. Tôi không... Trong lòng của tôi lúc nào tôi cũng mơ ước tôi có được người cha đấy. Được một lần để tôi ôm cha tôi được một lần thôi. Nhưng mà cái ước mơ của tôi nó không có được.
This secret that was in my family for so long had really weighed down both my mom and my grandmother. My grandmother, because she had to keep the secret to herself for decades and decades and decades, and my mom, because she so badly wanted the answers. It's really good for both of them to finally get the answers that they were looking for, whether it is who my grandfather is or what happened to this man who I loved 50 years ago. The most important thing for me is now I have that answer to what are you? Where do you come from? What I do with this information and how I build my life from here is what will define me the most.